Hello students, in previous lecture we have already started the concept of GDP and welfare is the gross domestic product and welfare of the nation. Students, in which we discussed can the gross domestic product of country is an index of the welfare of the country of the people. There are the three reasons this may be not correct, and we have already discussed the first reason, that is the distribution of the GDP. And today we are going to take the more information about the second reason, that is non-monetary exchanges. Then students, what is the non-monetary exchanges? The non-monetary exchanges means through the money. Students, all of you know, in our economy there are the so many types of the economic activities, but these economic activities are not evaluated in the monetary terms. Means the economic activities, the many economic activities, they are not evaluated in terms of the money. Then it is called the non-monetary exchanges. For example, the domestic services which perform at home by the woman, means the woman perform so many types of the domestic services at home, but they are not paid for it. Means here the exchanges here the exchanges take place informal sector without help of the money, then it is called the barter system. Means here in the barter system See students, here the exercise takes place for the sector without help of money, then it is called the barter system. Means in the barter system, the goods and services directly exchanged against each other without the help of money. Means here, in the barter system, money is not being used. So, these exchanges of the goods and services are not registered as the part of the economic activity. Why these exchanges are not registered as the part of economic activity? Because here, money is not used while exchanges the goods and services. And in underdeveloped countries, these kind of exchanges do take a place. Means in the underdeveloped countries, the goods and services directly exchanged without help of money, or they are directly exchanged against each other. So here, in the underdeveloped countries, these kind of exchanges, they are not counted in the GDP of the country. Therefore, the national income cannot be the clear indicator of the welfare of the society. Why the national income cannot the indicator of the welfare of the society? Because here the non-monetary exchanges, which refers only the goods and services which is produced, but they are not exchanged through the money. So this is all about the non-monetary exchanges, and these non-monetary exchanges, they are not the indicator or they are not the index of the welfare of the country. Then the next concept is the externalities. The third reason is the externalities.
Thank you.
sphere. The externalities means it is the cost or the benefit which is caused by the producer. That is not a financially receiver or which is not a financially incurred by the producer. Means here the externalities refers to the benefits or it also refers to the harms of the harmful or an individual which causes to the another form which they are not paid. Means the externalities, it may be the beneficial or it may be the harmful. Means there are two types. See, the externalities which refers to the benefits or the harms of one or an individual which causes to another for which they are not paid. Means it may be the positive externalities or it may be the negative externalities. We explain it with the help of an example. See here. See students, the externalities means it refers to the benefits or the harms of the perks of an individual which causes to the another, and for it they are not paid. Means the externalities, it may be the harmful or it may be a beneficial. Means there are the two types of the externalities, positive externalities and the negative externalities. See, there is a oil refinery and which refines the crude petroleum and sells it in the market. See, there is an oil refinery factory and which refines the crude petroleum, and these petroleum the factory sells in the market. Means here the value added of the refinery will be counted as the part of the GDP of country or as a part of the GDP of the economy. Means it is the positive externality. Why? Because here maybe the oil refinery which sells the petroleum in the market and maybe earn the income, and the value added of the refinery means which we get the income from the refinery, which will be counted as a part of the GDP of the economy. Means it is the positive externalities. And if suppose while carrying the production of refinery oil, it polluting the nearby rivers, means this may be harm to the people who use the water of this river. Means while carrying the production of the refinery oil, it may be polluting the rivers and it may be the harmful to the people who drink in the water of this river, or it may be also kill the fish. Means here the welfare or well-being of the people or maybe the animals is harmed. Means it is become the harmful to the people, so it is called the negative externalities. Means students, the externalities also is not the correct indicator of the welfare of the country. So students, we taken the information about the distribution of GDP as well as the non-monetary exchanges and the externalities, and these all are the not good indicators of the welfare of the country.